in the demo here, you are going to learn about SageMaker Canvas, actually. SageMaker Canvas, as a part of Studio, is a great way for you to get started with generative AI, particularly in a low-code, no-code environment. And so Canvas is an application inside of SageMaker Studio that's great for business analysts and anyone who wants to interact with language models without needing to actually write code in order to do that, which is really helpful. So let's take a look. All right, so here I am inside of SageMaker, and I'm going to navigate over on the left-hand side to Studio. And so SageMaker Studio, again, is a fully managed IDE for machine learning that actually decouples the UI from many, many different applications. So this visual that you're seeing right here provides you many applications and many features that you can use for your entire machine learning lifecycle. So, of course, JupyterLab is available if you want to set up a Jupyter environment and start running notebooks. You can also use a code editor, such as Visual Studio Code, to develop, if that's your preferred environment. RStudio is available here in addition to Canvas, which is what we're going to take a look at in a minute. You can connect into AutoML, you can run jobs in SageMaker Studio, such as model evaluation and training jobs. You can establish and then view pipelines that you have created. And then, of course, you have models that are pre-built for you in SageMaker Jumpstart. And so in SageMaker Jumpstart, we have hundreds of foundation models that are available for you to easily just, again, deploy and actually fine-tune and evaluate. So if we take a look at the Mixtral models, for example, you can see you have 5 Mixtral models here, including 8x7b Instruct, Instruct GPTQ, and then 8x7b. So I already have a model created for you, and I can see this in my endpoint. And so this is a Llama 2 chat model. So it's a really small language model that I'm going to use to chat with inside of Canvas, actually. And so we can take a look at this model. Again, I deployed it just using SageMaker Studio. This is running on a G5.8XL. So let's check out Canvas. So we're going to go up here to my applications in the top left. I'm going to click on SageMaker Canvas. And then I already have a Canvas application running, so I'm going to open this application. All right, so here we are in SageMaker Canvas. Again, many capabilities that I can use. In particular, we're going to navigate down to the left-hand side where it says Gen AI. And so I've already been chatting with my Llama 2 model you see here. And I can also query documents, actually. Let's set up a new chat. So in my new chat, I can point to Claude. So I'll just say, hi, Claude. How are you today? And so Claude responds back, which is lovely. And it's actually querying my documents. So let me set that to not query the documents. We should get a very different response. Great. Okay. And so this is Claude 2. I'm going to set up another chat here. And then I'm going to actually add a new model. So I'm going to say compare on the right-hand side. And then in this drop-down, I'm going to set up another model just to give you a sense of the choice that you have in using a variety of foundation models. So in SageMaker Canvas, you can use a number of models from Amazon Bedrock, actually. You can use Claude 2 that's in Bedrock in addition to all of the capabilities you see. You can also point to models available through SageMaker Jumpstart. So again, I already have Llama 2 7b chat set up, and you can see many of these other models available as well. So I'm going to close this, and then let's go talk to Llama 2 chat. All right, great. And so I'm going to ask it to suggest some interesting ideas about responsible AI. And so in Canvas, I can actually run both of these models at the same time on one prompt, and I can see the responses. So on the left-hand side, of course, I see responses coming in from Claude 2, which is a very large language model that's available through Bedrock, and then Llama 2 7B Chat, which is a very small language model available through SageMaker Jumpstart. And what's interesting to me is that on this question, both of the models seem to be doing fairly well. They're both talking about explainability. They're both talking about fairness. They talk about safety, privacy, and security. They look at continuous monitoring and improvement, and then control. So both of them clearly are doing well. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a retrieval augmented generation stack to this through clicking. It's a beautiful thing. So what I've done ahead of time is I went into Kendra, actually. So in Amazon Kendra, I created a index with recent papers from Amazon Science. So I downloaded about 10 research papers that just came out of the Amazon Science publishing blog, uploaded those to my S3 bucket, created an index in Amazon Kendra, and then now I can search this just to test it. So I asked it, what is a large language model? And let's just see this. So I get, you know, these answers that Kendra is suggesting, in particular with links to some of these papers that I just uploaded to my S3 bucket. Now back in Canvas, what I've done is I've added the permissions for Canvas to do queries on my index. And so now I'm going to add this query documents flag, and I can point directly to my index here. And so now let's ask, what is a good paper about responsible AI? And so both Claude 2 and Llama Chat will be looking inside of this query, and in particular, the retrieval to extract papers from what I provided directly. And they're also providing sources for these. All right, great. And so this is just a really easy way to get started with generative AI, start to understand the capabilities of large language models using Amazon SageMaker. And so with that, I hope you enjoyed this introduction. We're going to keep going. Thanks.